Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here in the Binding of Isaac Invicta Repentance Series. Happy Thursday, Mosh Pit. I hope you all are having a great start to your almost weekends here. And thank you very much for getting us another like streak counter down below. Man, it's great to see it back, Aaron. I couldn't do it without you guys and gals support in the Mosh Pit. Thank you all very much for it. We're now up to 7 out of 30, and we are going to continue to roll on. But first off, here's your meme of the day brought to you this time around. First off, brought to you by RubyHeart255. Title thread was new craziest run. As you can see here, we've got quite the trend going on. We've got multiple memes at this point that are just starting to become threads of their own, and I am all for it. So we now have the random seed effect every floor taking over the all items or trinkets runs. But now, after yesterday's insanity, I have a feeling that we're going to see a continuation of this one. So we'll find out. Thank you very much to RubyHeart and everyone who upvoted that one. Here we go. Let's hop on in and see what kind of start we got going on today. We got a D-Twanky and Bravo, Bravo, Sierra Echo, a Yankee Bravo, Papa 3. We've got great tiers, good damage to start off with, and we also have Bum Friend, which, Bum Friend, but we also have the D-Twanky, which is a great item for us to start off with because it allows us to have a lot of really early game shenanigans with pills and stuff that we aren't going to take or useless tarot cards and whatnot. Leading us to who knows. I mean, we talk about opening up the threads. Ooh. Okay, so this is what we got to do here. First off, let's hope that we end up getting enough money to just buy Black Candle just outright. But secondly, if we do have to bomb the donation machine, we have to make sure that we don't let Bum Friend take anything. And also, I have to say for the record that it's very nice not having to worry about my controls getting reversed or us sliding around on ice or anything like that. That's a scary time, man. You get a bomb here. If you don't know what I'm talking about, if you missed yesterday's Wacky Wednesday, you missed yourself a good one. It was an instant classic with the ending that happened. So we may not have had like some of the craziest like seed combinations, but it all culminated at the end of the run that made it an instant classic, which, again, thank you all very much for the support on that. I'm glad everyone enjoys my confusion and also dismay. And some panic in there. There was a slight bit of panic whenever your controls get completely just taken away from you, and then on top of that, you can't kill any enemy except they I don't want to ruin it. Just go watch it. What are you doing? All right, so we get a movement speed upgrade, which is one of the few stats that we really could use that we could stand to benefit from. And now we're going to take the risk. Well, first off, let's go into the curse room here. Okay, yeah. I don't like putting damage on a fresh soul heart, but, you know, do what you got to do. Super secret room's right there, but we only have one bomb. All right, so now here, okay, I'm gonna hit escape really quickly so we can explain the situation we're in. Right now, what we can do is we can bomb the donation machine and then pick up everything off the ground, and then that's that. Or we've got a full charge on the D20, and we stand to gain a lot more. But this is kind of a greed factor now built into this because we may not be able to get to every single coin because of the idiot known as Bum Friend. So there's also kind of a coin saving strategy here. Do we go for broke and risk it, or do we just get the guaranteed, almost guaranteed Black Candida? Yeah, that's enough coins in there to guarantee it. Panic. I got it. We got it. Get Black Candle. Good. Ah, you son. All right. This is not Isaac's tomb. This is Mr. Me. I mean, we got a golden key. We got some bombs. And Mr. Me gave us a soul heart. So, I mean, it's okay. I'm a little bit upset. But this is why no one likes Bum Friend, by the way. Ooh. Okay, well, the D20 ended up giving us a tiers up. We can get that chest here. We probably should. I didn't actually catch how many coins Bum Friend took from us, but I know that it was more than a few. Really? So you're telling me that the secret room is to the left of the curse room? Oh my goodness gracious. That would be Sacred Orb, and you know, we talk about them threads. We talk about them threads, and Isaac, if we did not use the D20 and got those bombs when we did, we could not have gotten a Tears Up and also ultimately led to a Sacred Orb drop. Wow. Okay, and we're off. A big room up here. We can definitely stand to benefit from using the reverse death card, which is basically Book of the Dead, especially when we have a bunch of egglets out here. So Sacred Orb. Sacred Orb is going to remove all low quality items from our run, and getting that on floor one is extremely unordinary. So hopefully we gain. Hopefully this puts us this sets us up for just an absolutely monster of a run, just a huge, just giant monster run. Because we don't have to worry about quality one, quality zero items in there. You know, it just makes things better. That Sacred Orb is the quintessential makes things better item that we all know and love, that I love. Anyway, here are these demon fires. Oh man, can't say no to card reading. Mama Mega, you know, Mama Mega is great, but card reading gets us free access into secret rooms, free access into boss rooms. We can skip entire levels. I mean, yeah, sign me the heck up. Backstabber as well. This run would be perfect if we didn't have you know who. The one who shall not be named. Not pointing any fingers or anything, I'm just saying. Because the problem is that we can't really roll anything with the D20 with you know who being around. Because we can't leave coins on the ground. The nicely timed arcade. Again, very rare to see it on floor two. Okay, so we got Backstabber. We also got a dead end here. D20's just cocked, locked, and ready to rock. I know where the secret room is to the left of here, but we don't have a bomb for it. Backstabber, of course, just the breakout star of last year, towards the end of last year anyway. Showing up just constantly, and honestly, again, I'm all for it. Wow, did you see how fast that fire shot? We were here, and that fire decided to cork up a shot. Game sometimes, man, I tell you. Backstabber again, it just does massive amounts of damage to enemies whenever you get the bleed effect on them and then they try to move, or if you have anything that can knock them back, causing them to take like momentum damage is what I've coined it. Yeah, this is not a good fight for Duke of Flies. Old Dookie is going to be old daddy here in a second. There we go, we get another tiers upgrade here for our soap. And yeah, I mean, little Abadabba Ding Dong's kind of whatever, but I will take, we'll take Little Horn. Let's go check out what's inside of our secret room. That's where I'm really interested because we have Sacred Orb. No, you're not taking that dime or this. A reverse temperance machine, which I'm just going to go ahead and just let go right now. I mean, we can re-roll it if we really wanted to try to maximize our use of the D20. See if we can get away with making some stuff on the ground here. Pill. Oh. Yeah, I mean, hey. He gave us another HP up, and then we can go for the temperance machine and get a blood bag, which is going to give us a movement speed up and HP up. So, I mean, you know, it's just when it all works out, it all works out. Sometimes. I don't want to say all the time, for sure. D20 leading up some big time plays, and we're trying to prevent Bum Friend from taking those away from us. I want to say thank you very much, everyone, for the support and the kind words to Papa Victa. He's feeling better. He's not healthy yet. He's not over the Backstreet Boys reunion tour, but he is getting better, thankfully. Very, very excited and blessed to hear that. So thank you again. I've been showing him the replies on Twitter and people saying nice things in the comments. So again, I personally want to thank you for doing that, because he doesn't, you know, it is, like I was saying on Monday, Tuesday, it was one of those days. It's a little bit, it's easy to not realize, like, how many people I can reach out to, and it's the scope of things is a little lost on him. Not because he's a tech idiot. He's just, you know, he's not plugged into this side of the world, you know, this understanding of this digital universe that we're basically in. So he was like, he said, wow. I mean, he didn't do like a Owen Wilson. We had Ipecac. Ipecac had its time to shine. I'll take Battery Baby. World card, party time, excellent. Yeah, he didn't do an Owen Wilson impersonation. He just said, wow, thank you. So he's on the mend, but he's getting there. So thank you very much again. And again, this week's episodes are going to be a little bit kind of truncated because I am doing stuff and trying to take care of Dad without actually going over there, but like getting medications and anything else that he needs from like the grocery store. So, you know, I've already apologized for it, but in case if anyone missed those episodes or if you just weren't paying attention, there's probably going to be no victory laps this week, just because I do, as soon as I'm done with this episode, I've got to go. But again, I appreciate, like, literally everyone has been supportive and they understand. Like, if you miss out on, you know, 20 more minutes of The Binding of Isaac, you know, I think you'll be okay for the year. But that being said, we're still going to get some episodes in. We're going to get some good runs in. It may be shorter run time, but, you know, we're getting runs in. A death's list or a death's touch, I mean, or just keep getting red portals left and right. I think the game's trying to tell me something. It's trying to tell me go get Papa Victor's medication. I ain't gonna rush through it. Speedball, which is our first of the syringe items that we're going to see here. You're seeing how nice it is to be able to just, like, say, like, the heck with most of the level and go straight to the boss. And normally the shop and the item rooms, not always, but sometimes, more often than not, let's put it that way, the item room and the shop, besides the boss room, the only two rooms that I even care about at any given level are relegated towards, relatively nearby, towards the boss room side of the map. So if you take the red portal, in other words, TLDR, if you take the red portal from card reading, chances are you're going to probably get everything that you want to on that side of the map, unless if you're like doing full clears or like got golden teleporter or something. I'm gonna buy the soul heart. We don't really need the world card. Okay, well, the Hierophant worked out to be very, very powerful for us. So, as you see here, we got everything. So I don't know where the secret room is. It could be, nope, never mind. It couldn't be there, but you know what? I'm fine with that. Now we can't use the red portal right now because we can't get out of boss rush But what we can do is we can go knock out the shop. Hypercoagulation is going to do absolutely nothing for us. We can knock out the shop and the item room in once. Then on the way back through the rest of this floor, we can look for the tinted rock. Pandora's box and the school bag are not going to be anything that we can take because we can't afford it. Man, we are moving. Look at that. Look at the backstab damage on Chubb. Also got hypercoagulation. Hypercoagulation is going to give us a red heart every time we take damage, much like Tainted Maggie. But it's very, very temporary, and also, like, yeah, it is something that we can roll through, though, with the D20, though. Revelations. I mean, it's depths, too, so we can just go ahead and use it. Stick with the D20. Now, what I'm really curious to seeing here is going to be this planetarium. What we got going on here. Another thing that we could do, you don't necessarily need to get the full card in Depths 2 if you have the D20, because the D20, if you go into Boss Rush and just start doing Boss Rush, chances are you're going to have a bunch of crap on the ground that you are going to be able to just roll anyway into, like, a teleportation card, so not that huge of a deal. But here's our full card anyway. I want Jupiter just because it's an annoying item to deal with, and also because you have to deal with the farting sound, and after yesterday, we've had more than enough of that, I can promise you. Oh, those wacky Wednesdays. Now, people, there have been some good suggestions for Sundays, and I'm considering a couple of possibilities. The problem, one of the more popular ideas for Sundays was to be like a subscriber Sunday, where the mosh pit, either via like social media polls or here on YouTube or community polls or maybe a Reddit thread or Discord, something like that, would determine everyone would vote or just nominate like a cool idea, and then like the upvotes would determine what we're going to do. I'm down for that, except that there'd be a very short time to vote on them. Unless if we did them a week in advance, which is something that, like, I could definitely do. But it really depends on, like, how long people have to go to vote and that sort of thing. And also when I record the episodes, too. Ooh. If we have card reading, we don't need it. We don't need mine. We don't need the mine, so we'll go Deadeye. Fool. So, like, I would do, like, one poll, let's say, 5 days in advance. But another thing, too, is that... Well, I completely lost where I was because we're moving way too fast. Another idea would be me just putting out like a couple of nominations that sounded good or sounded neat, and then just put up a vote just to see what the mosh pit votes on, like a couple days before I record the episode, that sort of thing. You know, there's a couple of ideas floating around for what we can do for Sundays, including bringing Random Runday back. I mean, like it's no secret that Sunday is always going to be the worst performing day of the week. Just based on its nature. I mean, people have church, you know, it's a weekend, it's right before work, so people got to get ready for school or, you know, whatever, do homework, and you know, I understand, like, that's no big deal, like, that's how it's just always going to be. But to spice it up and to give it like some appeal for people to want to get out and support the channel is, you know, I wouldn't be doing my job if I wasn't trying everything I could. So that's what Sundays are for. It's experimental, you know. Deadeye just absolutely dominating. Oh man, Lump of Coal plus Death's Touch. Lump of Coal plus Death's Touch plus Deadeye. Oof, brother, sister. You got yourself a real strong combination here. And you throw him Backstabber. Yeah, we're talking about gaming right now. This is a gamer run. I'm very fortunate here with these red portals, and I appreciate that because I just got a text from Papa Victor. We'll definitely do a victory lap in this one, but if I get a red portal, I'm gonna take it. Yeah, it's just an idea. And again, thank you very much, everyone, for offering up some suggestions, that sort of thing. And it also gives me a little bit of a gauge in seeing what you guys and gals want in terms of like themes and whatnot. Like, people really want to see different characters other than Eden. People want to see this type of challenge or that type of challenge. They like the really goofy off the wall stuff. I don't really want Brimstone, to be honest. I'm just being real with you. I should have rolled. Stupid. Because every single one of those coins could have turned into a chest, which would have turned into a secret room item, so... Well, actually, that's technically not true. They're not guaranteed secret room items. They're mega. One of those maps. This is one of those maps where the secret room was trying to act like it was a super secret room and just forgot. What was that double tap there, game? Okay. All right, game. We're taking some liberties here, are we? One big Isaac circle right there. And we're just still going. I mean, this all could have been avoided had we just gotten a red portal, I'm just saying. But we do have Juice's Shadow in case we need the backup, and that's just going to make it, like, even more painful on you, game. So, you know, you decide whether or not it's worth it. Oh. He's mascara plus Deadeye. Forget about it. Thumbs up for the victory lap. Second seed, X-Ray, Mike 6-7, Tango 9, Papa Foxtrot. Now, they still have not patched this, and I doubt that they will at this point. But if you have card reading and you go on victory lap, it will not work no matter what portal you see, period. So just keep that in mind. Ooh. That could be a fun re-roll here with the D-Twanky. Okay. Not as festive and fun as I thought it would be, but it's the thought that counts. All right, yeah, that was actually horrible. could not have gone any worse there, or at least it could not have been any less exciting. I mean... You know what, Larynx? Come on down. D20, thank you very much for your service. Thanks for showing us all those amazing threads that we pulled out of the first run. I think we're gonna let Larynx shine for a bit. Though that half price coupon's got me wondering. We haven't had Larynx in a while, so. First floor fallen. He's really fallen off. Now the portals will work. Be nice to get some kind of spectral tears here, if possible. Double soul hearts for us here, and that's going to be it. Yeah, again, I'm just going to be taking red portals here because Papa Victor needs something. But I'd say so far, 2023 it's really been great, man. It almost feels like, especially after the YouTube streams that we've been doing, like it feels like almost like a reconnection to the Mosh Pit, you know? Like, it's great seeing you guys and gals come out for the YouTube streams, and, you know, I miss streaming on YouTube and still on that same subject though, you know, the Twitch stream is doing very well. We've been having lots of fun with Isaac Madness and that sort of stuff. Also, of course, having a having a lot of, or not a lot, but a bunch of different games too to play on stream has also been a great joy. We get conjoined here, which is going to help us out with the fact that we got Tractor Beam. Here's our perfection, unfortunately. Man. I think we take Ceremonial Robes and we take Athame and go to Black Judas. Just a casual 40 damage, you know. Nothing big. Just 40 damage. Oh yeah, I forgot that we didn't... for some reason, I saw that empty room over there next to the dice room and thought that like we were on that side of the map. Okay, so we didn't get a red portal, and I wouldn't take it anyway. I'm going to take Halo of Flies just because it is going to be safer. We need to be slightly cautious with our HP, obviously, because we don't have a whole lot. That is some bright... That's some bright Deadeye right there. That's some genuine damage we got. And Guppy would also send this one through the moon in terms of our our damage is already kind of through the moon, but man, Guppy would just, it would take it to a different level. It would go past the moon. And take a soul heart for our troubles. Headed rock there, but I will go back and get. Yeah, this as far as pure like raw damage, like this one so far of the year anyway, this one definitely takes the cake. We've got a lot of DPS here. 4.53, and like our tiers aren't even maxed yet. But the way that Deadeye scales with everything, and top of that, another thing you have to consider is the scaling of Lump of Coal as well. Like, that's just doing buku amounts of damage. I don't think there can be a soul heart there because we didn't see it with Guppy's eye, but I figured I'd check. It's at, like, Deadeye is actually making it kind of difficult to see what's going on. Wow. I honestly did not know that Larynx could even proc a Thame. There's 9 lives, and that's another huge pickup for us, and that gives us 2 or 3 for Guppy. And we'll take Capricorn. Who's still alive over there, but you shouldn't be. Destroy that rock in the middle just because I think it's actually blocking some of our tears. I mean, this is just ultra mega buzzsaw death right here. As soon as our tears touch anything, they die. It's instant death. That is the level of damage we're talking about with our damage scaling here. The Thame, like, even though we don't have, like, we barely have positive luck, it's still proccing on almost every kill. This is big time player damage. Nah. Give a little old Mike Nolan. Nah. A red portal, unfortunately, but we get Sausage, which doesn't ruin Polar Invincibility because we don't have any. We don't have to worry about red hearts because we are Black Judas. Remember. We also have 9 lives anyway, so yeah. Go Maul Wrath real quick. Get out of there before we can get hit. those flies. I feel like this is not going the right way. What a run, man. Oh my god. It's even more jarring. It's even more jarring to the fact that, like, we have tractor beam. So my input on where I'm, like, facing is instantaneous. And if we have Deadeye, like, fully charged, just, like, blinding both eyes at once. More damage here in the form of Jesus Juice. And Money Equals Power. And Money Equals Power, multi-dimension baby, don't really need. I'd rather honestly just have the HP. The red portal, thank you very much, game. Lusty Blood, oh my gosh. All right, well, Papa Victa just texted me again, but you know what? We're going to fight Old Hushy anyway. Old Hushy. Old Hushy. That's going to be ourselves a chariot. As if we needed more tears and more splash damage. Oh my gosh. We'll add the apple, which gives us the razor blades. It would deal double damage. Yeah, that was not a very smart teleport there, Blue Baby. Larynx didn't do anything to bosses or to Hush's boss armor. Oh my goodness. Did you see the impact damage there of Cricket's body on all those flies that barely got a chance to spawn? That is absolute destruction. Another very merciful red portal here. Isaac just goes down. Isaac goes down in like 3 hits. Which really isn't even 3 hits. It's like actually 12 hits. Worm Buddy! How you doing, Worm Buddy? Kidney Stone would actually, I think, kind of ruin this build because we just don't even need it. And yeah, that's going to be it. All right, fine. Fine, but you better give us a red portal here, game. It did not. Just imagine if we had spectral tears. That's the only thing we're missing. That and flying. I mean, really, Spear of the Night would be it. The shadows, sure. Why not? Get Bookworm, which is just going to add even more projectiles to our combined projectile ability, thanks to the tractor beam. Little Horn again, because I mean, hell, why not? Like, the splash damage from the sides are hitting, like, targets that we're not even aiming. I mean, it's just, it's pure just domination. Fun card, thank you very much. What a run, man, what a run. So, if you enjoyed this episode, everyone, assuming this is Delirium, it is. Thank you for watching. Make sure you click the like button. Remember, we just need 3,000 likes and counting. And we do have the double and triple like streak rewards as well down below. As you can see at the beginning of every single video that qualifies for it, 6,000, 9,000, 12,000, all that kind of good stuff is still valid for extra like streak totals. And again, thank you all very much for all the kind words for Papa Victa. Hopefully after this weekend, he's going to be fully recovered and we don't have to worry so much about him. And you know, he can get back on his feet. Helping himself. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, everyone. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. Like, there's a patron of mine like Samile or Sam, Fred, Garrett Trimmer, Nicholas, and Oi Skull WTF. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.